Hi students, I am Aruna, lecturer in computer science, Sarsriyar College Peruma Neluru. Today we are going to discuss about hyperlinks and list. This is the continuation topic for the previous video. This is also basic HTML topic.
I'm going to discuss about a hyperlink. What is a hyperlink? This hyperlink several documents. How it links? By using which tag? Web page can contain various links that take you directly to other pages and even specific parts of a given page. You can click on a link and jump to another document. These links are known as hyperlinks. When I click on a link, that link goes to another document. How it links? With the help of hyperlinks, an anchor tag is used for linking documents. This linking of documents concepts is known as hyperlinks. How we navigate between the web documents? Hyperlinks allows visitors to navigate between websites by clicking on words, phrases, and images. When you move the mouse over a link, the mouse arrow will turn into a little hand. If I place a mouse on the text where we are going to link the document over a link, it will turn into a little hand symbol. Is the link should always be in a text format? No, it can be either in any HTML element format or image format. We can use text, images, other HTML elements. A link does not have to be a text. A link can be an image or any other HTML element. Thus, you can create hyperlinks using text or images available on a web page. What tag is used for specifying these links? We are using anchor tag. It is represented with A. A link is specified by using HTML tag A. The anchor tag defines a hyperlink that links one page to another page. With the help of this anchor tag only, we will link the documents. Anything that is placed in between anchor tag that becomes a part of the link, and the user can link that part to reach the link document. How we will reach the other document? By clicking on the link. Where the link is placed? That link is placed in between anchor tags, opening tag and closing tag. Section has four tags. One is address, optional attributes, link, close tag. The address is referred document. What is a reference document? When we click on the link, that should be referred to or jump to other page. That is given in an address. Here we are using href tag for that. And the next one is optional attributes. Optional attributes are name and target attributes. If we want those attributes, we can specify in an anchor tag, or else we can omit it. Next one is a piece of text to be displayed as a link. How we identify it is a hyperlink? A small text that is written to be displayed as a link. Click here, show, go, like this. This is the text that is displayed as a link. Finally, the closing tag. These are the four sections of a link tag. Let's see the syntax of a hyperlink. Which tag is using? Anchor tag. Anchor tag is used for linking of documents. In the previous slide, we have seen the link has four sections. First one is address, optional attributes, piece of text displayed as a link, close tag. Here we are using anchor tag. Address where the refer document is used. Here href equals to URL. This is the address where goes when we click on this link text. Optional attributes are name and target. Attribute name equals to string. Target attribute, target equals to string. This is the text displayed on a link. What is this? Link text. Finally, close anchor tag. See the example. Ahref equals to links.html. Click here. Close anchor tag. Here, click here is the text. If I place the cursor and click here, then it goes to the link.html page. Links to link.html in the same directory. Another example, ahref equals to, now I am producing the URL as website http://www.sircrwomen.in. Text that is used on the text that is used for referring link is visit sircr college for women. Close anchor tag. Now if I click on this visit sircr, if I click or link on that text, it will goes to a website. Which website? sircrwomen.in. Links to other website. Attributes of link are name attribute and target attribute. Name attribute. The name attribute specifies the name of the anchor. The name attribute is used to create a bookmark inside an HTML document. If you see the example, A, name equals to tips. Useful tips section, close. Target attribute. This attribute is used to specify the location where link document is open. The following are the possible options. When I click on the text, it should open a new document or a new page. Where it opens? For that we are using target attribute with the values blank, self, parent, top. Blank means a link document opens in a new window or a new tab. Self opens on the same window as it was clicked. Parent opens the link document in parent frame. Top opens a link document in full body of the window. These are the target attribute values. If I place a blank, ahref equals to index.html, target equals to blank. Index.html page is link. Where it opens? It opens in a new window or new tab. If I place the target equals to self, this index.html page is opened itself or in the same window where I clicked. Next one is parent. Target equals to parent opens in a parent. Next one is top. Target equals to top opens in body. By default, links will appear as follows in all browsers. Three types of links are there: unvisited, visited, active. Unvisited link means we doesn't click that link. If I click that link and I open that document, then it is a visited link. Active link. An unvisited link is underlined and blue. A visited link is underlined and purple. An active link is underlined and red. We can easily identify the links. This is our sample program for hyperlink. We all know that we are using HTML language. So entire document should be enclosed in HTML. Here I am using H1 tag, paragraph tag. Now we are using hyperlink. For hyperlink, we use an anchor tag. Ahref equals to, I am producing URL, sircrwomen.in. Target equals to blank. Visit sircr college for women. Close anchor tag. Let's see how this example will execute. For that, you have to write the program in a notepad. In the previous class, we discussed that all these HTML code should be written on an editor like notepad. Save it with an extension .html and run on a web browser. I have written this HTML code in notepad and I saved with the file with hyper.html. The output of this program is like this. This is our hyperlink. If I click on this, it will link other document or it will open other document, or else it jump to another page from this environment. So I'm click, if you observe this, the now it is in pointer, cursor is in pointer shape. If I place this on the link, then it is turning into a little hand symbol. There are three types of links: visited, unvisited, active link. Now I didn't click any link, that's why these are appearing in blue. See here, if I click it, it is turning into red. Now the link is active. This is a previous example for previous class, that is about basic tags like heading tag, paragraph tag, bold, italic, underline, pretext, subscript, superscript. If you observe this, here in this program I didn't specify any target attribute. That's why if, when I click on the link, it is opening on the same window or the same tab. If you observe here, it is opening here only. If I click on visit search URL Roman, here I specify target equals to blank. See here. Here I specify target equals to blank. Whereas in second anchor tag, I didn't specify the target attribute. If it doesn't specify any target, by default it is in self. Self means it's open where it is clicked. Here I am clicking HTML format text here. Then it is opening here itself in the same window or same tab. Now I am clicking this. If I click this, I am using target equals to blank. Then it will open on in a new window or new tab. It is opening a new tab. This is hyperlink. Means it is referred or else linked to another document. Here I wrote the code. If I am clicking this link, it is going to another page. In that page, it is opening our college website. See once again. Here I am clicking this link. This is called hyperlink. If I click on this, it is opening the URL. I have given here the URL is searchurlwoman.in. So document is linked with this. This is about hyperlinks. Next we move on to list tags. Why we use these list tags? In previous case we have seen several tags. In all those cases we use a single items or single elements. Whereas if we want to group a set of related items, then we use list tags. List tags are of three types. One is unordered list, ordered list, definition list. A HTML list allows web developers to group a set of related items in lists. HTML offers web authors three ways for specifying lists of information. All lists must contain one or more list elements. List elements may contain unordered list, ordered list, definition list. These are the HTML list tags. LI tag defines the list. UL tag defines an ordered list. OL tag defines an ordered list. DL tag defines a description list. DT tag defines a term in a description list. DD tag describes the term in the description list. LI tag. The alert tag defines a list item. We can take many items. Each and every item should be enclosed by a alert tag. Alert tags is used where these alert tags are used in both order list and unordered list. Syntax for this alert list is alert list item close alert. Here in this example, I am taking alert apple, alert close. Opening tag grapes, close list item. Next type of list tag is unordered HTML list. What is an unordered list? An unordered list is a collection of related items that have no special order or sequence. It doesn't follow any order or sequence of the list items. An unordered list starts with UL tag. Which tag is used for specifying unordered list? UL tag. All the items should be enclosed in list tag. This li tag is enclosed in UL tag. Each list item starts with li tag and ends with close li tag. The basic unordered list has a bullet in front of each list item. I have taken, for example, I have taken apple, grapes, banana. These three fruits in front of each and every item before apple, a bullet is appeared. Similarly, grapes, a bullet is appear before that. Banana, before that, a bullet is appear. This list item will be marked with bullets, small black circles by default. If it doesn't specify any bullets, we have three types of values. Type attribute used for this. If it doesn't specify, then the bullet appears in small black circles. Attribute for UL tag is type. The following are the values for type attribute. First one is square, disk or circle. Square sets the list item marker to a square. So the bullet is in the shape of square. Circle sets the list item marker to a circle. Disk sets the list item marker to a bullet. If it doesn't want any type, if the type is none, nothing is marked, the list item will not be marked. See the example. For unordered list tags, we use UL tag. All the list of items should be enclosed in li tag. All these li tags should be enclosed in UL tag. Here UL tag is using type attribute. We can use disk, circle or square. This is a syntax of UL tag. See the example. UL type equals to what I have taken square, list of items. I have taken three items, apples, grapes, bananas. All these items should be enclosed in list tag, and this list of items is enclosed in UL tag with an attribute square. Now each and every item, list item, in front of that we will have a bullet. Now this bullet shape is square because I specified the type equals to square. If I didn't specify anything, none, then no bullet is here. Next type of tags are ordered HTML lists. An ordered list is a collection of related items that have order or sequence. Name itself indicates that this list follows a sequence or an order for the elements. An ordered list starts with the OL tag. OL tag also contains several lists. That's why each and every list item should be enclosed in li tag. Each list item starts with li tag. In the previous case, we in front of every element, we will find a bullet. Here, in front of each and every item list, we will have a number. By default, item list is marked with numbers. The basic order list has number in front of each item list. The list items will be marked with numbers by default. The numbering starts at 1 and is incremented by 1, or each successive ordered list element tagged with li. Here we are using two types of attributes. One is type attribute and the other one is start attribute. In a previous case, unordered list follows only a type. here we are using a start attribute also, from where the type should begin. Number, if I place a number 6, from where it starts, the type attribute has specified a number, type equals to 1. Where it has to begin the number? From 6. I told to start with 6. For that we are using this type attribute and start attribute. Type attribute is used to specify the type of number you like to display before each item. By default, it is an integer number starting from 1. Following are the possible options. We can use 1 or small a or capital A, or Roman numbers capital 1, Roman number small 1. Start attribute is used to specify the starting point of the numbering you need. These are the examples for OL tag. OL type equals to 1. Start, I said the tag attribute start with the start attribute with the value 3. Then a numerical value begins with 3. The type of tag is, OL tag is, begins with numerical values 1, 2, 3. I stated to start with 3. Then the number begins from 3, 4, 5. Similarly, OL type equals to Roman number 1, start with 3. Initially, Roman number 1, 2, 3. I stated to start with Roman number 3. Then the numerical indications begins with Roman number 3. Similarly, small Roman number 3. Let us, OL type equals to A, small a, start 3. So, alphabets begins with A, B, C. I said to start with 3. That's why the letter starts with small c. OL type equals to capital A, start equals to 3. Letter starts with capital C. This is the syntax for ordered list. OL type equals to various options. We have seen that A, 1, small I, Roman numbers. Start equals to N. N specifies the integer value where it begins. List of items enclosed with LI tag. Finally, close OL tag. This is the example. OL type equals to, I have taken the type equals to A. Apple, grapes, banana. In front of apple, A. Next is followed by B. Next is followed by C. This is the difference between an ordered list and unordered list. Unordered list doesn't have any order. Whereas coming to the ordered list, it follows a sequence or order of numbers, elements, all this. OL use, unordered list use UL tag. Ordered list use OL tag. Both use a list of items with list item tags. Next list tag, that is description list. HTML description list. A description list is a list of terms with a description of each term. For that we are using tags like DL, DT, DD. DL tags defines the description list. DT tag defines the term or name of the item. DD tag describes each term. HTML supports a list style which is called definition list, where entries are listed like in a dictionary. Description list uses these different types of tags, that is definition list, which uses DL tag, that is used to define a definition list. It is a conjunction with DT and DD. Syntax for definition list is DL tag, open DL, content, or list of DT tags and DD tags, close DL tag. Next one is definition term. Tag name is DT. The DT tag defines an item in a definition list. Definition terms marks items whose definitions will be provided by the next definition. DT tag is used in conjunction with DL and DD. syntax for DT is open DT, content close DT. Description of items. The DD tag is used to describe an item in a definition list. If you want to describe any item that is placed, term is placed in DT and the description is placed in DD. DD describes the definition list. For example, if I place a word coffee in DT, I would like to say a description line for that coffee. Tastes good, smells good. That is about DT coffee. If it is milk, if I take a term milk, the description list provides milk is rich of calcium, all this. Whatever you want, we can write it in DD tag. The DD tag is used in conjunction with DL and DT. What we write inside the DD, inside a DD tag, you can put paragraphs, line breaks, images, links, etc. Tag that is used for a description of items is DD. Syntax for DD is open DD, content close DD. This is the program for definition list. For specifying definition list, we use a tag DL, term DT, description DD. So here see the example. DT is definition list. In that I am writing a list of terms and their definitions and descriptions in DD. This is description. Next term is HTML. Description of HTML is hypertext markup language. Next term is WW. Description for that is World Wide Web. The output of this program will appear like this. Let's see the example. Open notepad. I have written this here. Saved with the UL tag. Saved with UL.html. The output is like this. So here in this program I have written only two DTs. One is definition list here. Another one is HTML. These are terms. This is a description for that term. For arranging list like this, we use description list. This is ordered list. This is unordered list. Here you see the example. UL type equals to none. That's why there is no bullets before in front of any item. In order tag, I didn't specify any type. By default, if I doesn't specify any type, it follows numbers. This is about a definition list. These are the frequently asked questions here. How do I create a link? By using an anchor tag. With the help of href attribute, you can specify the URL of the document where you want to link. In this way, we can create our link. How do I create a link that opens a new window? Using a target attribute, where does our link opens in a new tab? When I place a target attribute with a value blank. Use attribute target. Target equals to blank. Here I didn't give any URL. It opens a new window, unnamed window. Data is open in a new window. How do I create the order or sequence for list item? Use OL tag. These are the topics we discussed about HTML, anchor tag, that is link. Hyperlinks are used for linking of various documents, transferring from one page to another page, or else it can go to the jump or to the refer document. In a anchor tag, we can use attributes like a target. And coming to the list, list is used to group a set of related items. In that, we have seen three types of list: ordered list, unordered list, and definition list. Unordered list it doesn't have any specific sequence or orders, whereas ordered list follows a sequence or orders. For that we use a tag type attribute, type attribute for world tag, and starts with a numbering, a definition list with different tags. This is about list and hyperlink tags. List is used for grouping of related items. Anchor tags is used to link various documents. Thank you. Have a nice time.